Just like as humans, there are two things we do. Remember, are these pets or wild animals?
Wild.
Okay, making sure. Since they are wild animals, they are unfortunately not house trained. That is why I have this amazing thing called my splat mat. I know, it has a name, it does its job. So if they go to the bathroom, it's okay. And usually they do it right when they are coming out of the box. Like they know they're coming out somewhere scary. That's when they go. I also have newspapers and Clorox wipes, so if they have an accident, we can clean it up. But if they have an accident, do you think they're going to feel safe if everyone starts laughing at them and making noises? No, so we're just going to have to pretend it didn't happen. The last thing is, if they get nervous, they might shake a lot. They might shake, because think about it. As humans, if we get scared, do we shake sometimes? Yeah, owls do that too. And they've been in their travel boxes for a little while, so they might also want to stretch, just like how after a long trip, you want to stretch. If they stretch their wings or shake their wings a little bit, are we going to make lots of noises?
They do.
CJ, this is their poop.
Alright. The first owl that we are going to meet is the tiniest owl that I brought today. It is also one that I do not have in the slideshow. So I get to teach you a little bit about him. Just a reminder, we have to be as quiet as possible. So I'm going to request that for the time being, we save all our questions until the end. I will be here afterwards. I will answer as many questions. But if we hold them in, it'll make my house feel a lot safer. And they can be out longer. Because if they get scared, they have to go up. I see the phones. Feel free to take pictures. Go ahead. Yeah, grab them now. Everyone wants to know if like the owls get scared of them. Nope. They're fine.
Flash.
Oh, nice and quiet, everybody. I will move around so you can get better looks at them. We're just getting them out, let them get situated to the room first. So the first owl that we're meeting is one we didn't learn about. This is an eastern screech owl. And all the owls that live with us at Chewonki are injured in one way or another, so they can't be released back in the wild. Because he can't take care of himself. Actually, this one's a girl, so herself. But she couldn't take care of herself. And that's okay, because at Chewonki, we feed him every day, we clean up after him every day. Oh, sit on your bottom, bud. There we go. And we make sure that they have a really happy life. So we build their rooms especially for them. And this teeny tiny owl is full grown. This is as big as she's going to get. So she is a tiny little owl. But she has some really special ways of surviving out in the wild. If you look at her colors, she's got brown. She's got gray, she's got black and white, so she can hide in the trees and hide from other animals and even hide from people. And the only real defense that this tiny little owl has is to stand as still as possible and hopefully hide. So that's why she's so still right now. She's like, if I don't move, nobody will see me. All the owls that live with us do have names, but that's because we work with them every day, so it'd kind of be a little silly if we didn't name them and we were just like, hello, owl. Her name is actually based off of where she came from. But she came a really long way to be at Chewonki. This owl came all the way from Georgia. She was found injured down in Georgia in a place called Fayetteville. So her name's Faye. And little Faye is all the way up here with us at Chewonki. And since she's a Georgia native, she doesn't really like the cold. So in the winter, we have a special house that's built for her inside at Chewonki, so she can stay nice and warm all year round. Like I said, we make sure they have really good lives with us, because this is like their way of earning their keep, I like to say. They come out, they work a little bit, they meet people, and when they go home, I want them to be as happy and as comfortable as possible, don't you? Yeah. So the reason that Faye is looking at me so much is because she only knows me. Think about it. You guys are all strangers. She doesn't know you. She only knows me. So she's keeping an eye on me. And as long as I don't look scared or nervous, she's like, well, I don't have anything to worry about. Colleen's fine. I'm fine. Which is kind of funny and also a little annoying when I try to show her face to people. Because she does not want to do it. She's like, I want you. But it's also a really good chance for us to see that 270 degree head turn. Or at least as far as my wrist can.
We want to stay here. We want to go up.
I want to go upstairs.
Yeah.
Alright, so I'm going to put dear sweet Faye up, and we're going to move on to my next owl. Thank you guys for so quiet and so calm. We'll get to them when we get to them. Sound good, bud? We work our way through. Really well. She knows people at Chewonki really well. I have my finger. Look, it's a normal size finger. I'm not tricking you here. It's not like some weird magic show. I'm going to touch my dear sweet owl friend on the top of her head. And you're going to see just how much fluff she has. Ready? I told you she's a bunch of fluff. And the only reason she's letting me do this with one finger is because she knows me. Remember, does she know you guys? No, you're a bunch of strangers. So she wouldn't let anybody just walk up and touch her. We have to build trust with the bird before we take them on program. We have to let them get used to our voice. We take them out around at work so they get used to us moving with them. They want to feel safe with us. Because we take them all over the state and meet lots of people. So they better have at least one friendly face there. She does have a name just like Faye. And her name is actually Luna. Alright, so Luna and I are going to walk around. Remember, please stay seated so you can get photos. Learned how to hunt a porcupine. Oh, yep, save it, bud. they do eat skunks, they eat anything, I like to say, that is smaller than them or the same size as them, because they're a really tough hunter. And the main thing that they use to hunt those animals is their feet, which are currently standing on my hand. Ready for one more activity? This activity does not involve any talking. It does not involve moving our bodies. The only thing it involves is one hand. You're going to make a fist with that hand and squeeze as hard as you can. Okay, stop squeezing. The average adult human has anywhere from 80 to 100 pounds. Grip strength. That's how strong our grip strength is. We can squeeze our hand. This owl here starts out at 500 pounds per square inch, meaning he is 5 times stronger in his feet than the strongest adult alive. So if he's not happy and he gets mad at me, you can see what happens. But unlike a normal adult great cordell, he won't do that. Because the reason that this owl lives with us is because he is actually blind in one eye and was found as a baby blind in one eye. And normally an owl can be released back in the wild if they're an adult and they're blind, find themselves injured with one eye. Because they're really good at listening. They don't need their vision in both their eyes because they turn their heads so far. Since he was a baby though, they learned their vocal skills from their parents. And nobody was able to find some adult great cordells to teach this guy how to be an adult great cordell. So he never learned that he was a big daddy of the sky. He always will think he's a baby. And part of the way that he thinks he's a baby is by the sounds he makes. He actually doesn't even know how to make his adult sounds. He just makes his little baby calls, and he'll have temper tantrums on my glove when he gets mad. Just like a little kid. He does have a name, and his name is Archimedes. But we call him Archie for short. So little Archie here, he's like the big baby that I take on programs. He doesn't know that he's big and strong. He doesn't know all his potential. But I think it's pretty cool. Alright guys, so I'm going to put dear sweet Archie up. I'm not going to be able to move around with him, unfortunately, but he is big enough, so we will take a minute for anybody that's in the back of
your picture.
Luckily he is like 3-4 times bigger than the first one, so I think you'll be able to see him.
comment.